In this unit, we'll learn about router queue management. As we know, the router has a key role, which is routing the messages entering it to the right directions. We will learn the algorithm which the router employs to know which exit the information should be routed to further in the path. In this unit, we'll learn how accumulating packets in the router memory and then deleting them after sending is managed. Each router has a memory capacity, generally called a buffer, which is managed as a queue. Using the buffer, the router accumulates incoming packets. Routers work in the store and forward method, storing packets and forwarding them. Routers have to store packets in the buffer in order to analyze them, sometimes manipulate them, and only then to forward them. When the rate of packets arriving into the router is higher than the rate at which it can transmit the data, the queue gets filled. In the event that this situation lasts for a long time, the queue will fill entirely and packets will be dropped, that is, not saved in the buffer. The rate of packet arrival and transmission away from the router depends on multiple parameters, such as the link capacity at entry, the link capacity at the exit, the router speed, etc. The time that a packet spends waiting in the line in the router is called the queuing delay. There are four parameters delaying packets passing through the router. The first cause is called process delay, which is the time it takes the router to check for an error in the packet and decide which line to move the packet out to. Process delays usually take less than a millisecond, that is, less than a thousandth of a second. The second cause for delaying packets in a router is queuing delay, the time of waiting in line. That is the time the packet queues after processing to wait to be transmitted. The third cause is called transmission delay, that is, the time it takes to transmit the packets to the line. As we learned in previous units, the transmission time is equal to the size of the packet, which is usually denoted as L, divided by the bandwidth, which is usually denoted as R. The fourth cause for delaying a packet passing through a router is propagation delay, that is, the time it takes to propagate a packet, which is the time from the router's end of transmission until the packet is fully received in the router on the way or at the destination point. The propagation time is equal to the distance of the router from the next point divided by the progress speed of a single bit on the line. Note that the transmission time and propagation time are two very different things. Transmission time is the time it takes to transmit a packet into the line, whereas propagation time is the time it takes a single bit to get from place to place. Usually, we'll look at the propagation time of the last bit in the packet, because it is the one that we care about. Because if it gets to its destination, then we're assured the rest did too. Likewise, the propagation time on a line is generally measured in hundredths of millions of meters per second, but depends on the type of line. In order to explain how routers work in terms of queue management, we'll use an analogy to the transportation problem called the caravan analogy. Let's say every bit is represented by a car. Every packet is a caravan containing 10 cars. That is, the size of the message is 10 bits. The cars come in at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour. Every router is represented by a toll booth, which delays every car for 10 seconds. The distance to the next toll booth is 100 kilometers. How long will it take all cars from the moment of arriving at the first toll booth until they all reach the second toll booth? This calculation will include the number of cars, that is, 10 times 12 seconds of processing in the first toll booth, which gives us 120 seconds. This is the total time it takes to process all the cars, and that is why at this stage, the last car is on its way towards the second toll booth. We'll add to this number the time it takes the last car to reach the second toll booth, which is the distance between the booths divided by the speed. That is 100 kilometers divided by 100 kilometers per hour, and we get another 60 minutes. For the total of the entire process, we'll add the two numbers and get 62 minutes. Note that we added to the queuing time only the propagation time of the last car, because during this time, the cars that left first already arrived. Now let's assume the speed of the car is 1,000 kilometers per hour, and the processing time at the booth is a full minute. In this case, the cars will reach the second booth even before the first booth finished processing all of them. A similar calculation will yield a result where the first car gets to the second booth when there are still three cars waiting for processing in the first booth. This is an example of two booths that represent two routers on the route. What happens if there are 100 routers? How do we handle that? In order to estimate the queuing time in a router, we'll use R to denote the bandwidth, that is, the speed at which data can be transmitted on the line, and the size of the packet with L, and the rate of packets arriving in a router with A. It is very important to adjust all measurement units to the same unit. For example, all in bytes or all in bits, for the calculation to be mathematically correct. We'll look at three situations of the ratio A times L divided by R. If the number we get is close to zero, that means the queuing time in the router is short because the router gets rid of packets at a high rate, or at a rate close to the one packets arrive at. If the number is close to one from below, then the packets are waiting for a relatively long time in the router queue. And if the number is higher than one, that means the rate of packet arrival into the router is higher than the rate it gets rid of them, and that the delay increases because the queue is filled. Theoretically, if the queue size is infinite, then the delay can also be infinite if more and more packets arrive infinitely. In the case of a finite queue, which is what happens for all cases, packets coming into the queue are simply not saved and therefore don't reach their destination. That can be treated as infinite delay. As I've mentioned, in the case of a packet coming into a full queue, it gets tossed. This doesn't promise that it will not reach its destination, because there can definitely be a situation where the previous router sent the packet again, or the original sender transmitted it twice because it got no response from the receiver. Some of the protocols that are required to ensure reliability of communication will transmit the packet a second time, and others of the protocols will not. What is throughput? Throughput is defined as the rate data arrives between two hosts, that is, from sender to receiver. Throughput refers to the receiver host and therefore includes all delays existing en route from sender to receiver. We measure throughput as a unit of volume relative to a unit of time. For example, the number of bits per number of seconds. We'll look at two kinds of throughput: instantaneous throughput, the rate at a particular moment, and average throughput, which is defined as the average of instantaneous throughputs over time. We can use the analogy of running water from an origin to a destination through a path consisting of a number of pipes of different sizes. Obviously, the narrower a pipe determines the rate of water going through because it is the bottleneck. Things get more complicated when there are several data sources and several destinations which share transmission lines. For the sake of demonstration, we have 10 sources and 10 destinations, and we assume that the common line is capable of containing all transmissions and dividing the accumulated capacity between them. The common line has a transmission capacity R, and each entering line has a rate of RS, whereas every existing line has a rate of RC. In this case, the throughput rate for every pair of hosts, origin and destination, will be the minimum of R over 10. Because R gets divided between all 10 hosts, between RS and RC. Because the smaller throughput determines the rate and is a bottleneck. If we assume the R is very big, which usually happens, we will get that the throughput between each pair is the minimum between RS and RC. In this unit, we learned how router queues are managed and what network throughput is.